Raw Honey. That's the name of this podcast. Why? Because sometimes it's going to be raw and sometimes it's going to be sweet. Man, I tell you what, man, I love that. All right. And if you're not free, I can help you get free. We'll talk more about that a little bit. Hey, my name is Paul Rosinski, and this is Raw Honey. Why Raw Honey? Because sometimes it's raw and sometimes it's sweet. Well, I have a guest with me today. His name is Tony Nash, and he has AZEE Business Solutions. And I just want to welcome you to Raw Honey. How are you doing today?
Yeah, Pastor Paul, thanks for having me on the show. I'm excited to be here.
Awesome. Hey, Tony, why don't you just tell us a little bit about who you are, your business, and things like that. I know he's helping me do a podcast, I'll tell you that right now, and figuring all this out and helping our team. Doing a great job, by the way.
You're a quick study. You're a quick study, and you're catching on right away here. But yeah, as you said, my name is Tony Nash, not Todd, as some have referred to me.
But AKA that,
off camera. Yeah. My name is Tony Nash. I'm the owner of AZEE Business Solutions in Owosso, Michigan. It's in the middle of nowhere. Actually, it's near Lansing. And we are a full service branding and marketing solution. We do everything from web design and graphic design, social media management, promotional video production, and yes, podcast production. And that's why we're here today. And we're excited about it.
Awesome. And I got to tell you, just doing a great job. You know what I mean? I'm just very impressed. Came right in, just had things organized, ready to go, which I love. And, you know, and so just totally impressed so far. So thanks for coming. Thanks for helping us out.
It's our pleasure. Our team is good. We're excited to be here. We're excited to help you get this off. You got a good message. That's going to be a, you know, that's what's going to make the show win. So we're excited to help you get it out there.
Good deal. That's a little pressure on me, but hey, we'll handle that part.
The jury's still out, I guess.
We'll see. We'll find out. Yeah. A year from now, if anybody's still watching this, we'll find out.
We'll refer back.
Good deal. Won't be because you didn't promote it well.
That's true. It's awesome. All on you. It's all on you.
It is.
We know I'm going to perform. It's all on you, brother.
I love pressure. It is so good. Awesome. But, you know, I was talking with Tony earlier, and we were talking about we both have something in common, and that common thread in our life is Jesus Christ.
Amen. Absolutely.
And super great, you know. God is just great. And I love how he expresses himself through different people. I mean, we all have different gifts. We have different abilities, different viewpoints, and different things like this. And we were talking about viewpoints.
Yeah,
you know, even though you and I have a common thread, Jesus, we can still see things from different viewpoints.
No question about it.
And just because we see things differently doesn't mean we need to be enemies.
That's right.
You know,
that's absolutely right. You know, I think that being around different people and hearing different point of views and having friends that think differently, that's what makes the world go around. That's what makes America great. And obviously today in the world that we're living in, man, it's almost like if you don't agree with somebody, you become their enemy. And I think a lot of this we talked about is social media. People want to put their opinions out there and they don't really have context with it. You don't see the heart behind the person that's saying that. And I think the majority of people, when they post that angry post on social media, they're in their own way trying to do what they think is right to help mankind, to help humanity. But a lot of times it comes across as just anger or or apathy or a lack of caring. And I think it's so important today, more than ever, that we do things like this, that we sit across from each other.
Yeah.
Even if that means we have to be 6 feet apart. I don't know if we're quite that far apart today, but.
No, just for political correctness, this is a 6 foot table.
6 foot,
it
looks
right
like
here.
That to me.
Yeah. Well, we do have these little guards.
We have the face mask filter. Yeah. So.
Hi, let's have a conversation today. Okay.
But I think it's so important that we have conversations face to face, that we hear what somebody's saying. And
absolutely.
If somebody disagrees with us, that's okay. It at least helps us understand where they're coming from.
You know, I agree with that. There's so many times where I'm even just asking a question on social media.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't know what to call it, but Facebook syndrome or whatever. A lot of people are getting angry.
Angry.
There's a lot of angry people. I just ask a simple question, and it's from not even an accusational type.
Right.
You know.
Just trying to find out
just,
the answer.
I just
or
want
where they're coming from.
I want to talk about, yeah. And they just take it like I am coming against them. And how dare you think this? And I'm just like, chill. Chill.
I had a situation recently where a friend of mine posted a meme. It was a cartoon, and it was basically some sort of a cartoon that was referencing, you know, the stereotypical redneck conservative with the MAGA hat on versus something that had to do with BLM.
Okay.
And it was really unclear what the meme was saying. I mean, it was clear that it was the two caricatures were clear.
Right.
But what the meme was trying to say, I didn't understand. And so I asked, hey, could you just explain that to me? And the person got so upset that I didn't understand what it meant. And they said, maybe you should make more black friends. And I was like, I said, I wasn't trying to start a debate here. I just wanted to know what the meme was. As a graphics person, as a branding person, as me being a person that tries to put design in to say something all by itself, I just didn't understand the meme. And of course, after conversation, she understood that I was just asking a question, but she thought that I was kind of coming out with this. I was refuting the meme, and I didn't even know what it meant.
And I was like, I can't refute it. I don't know what it says.
I don't know what it's trying to say, right?
Right.
So, it's just one of those things right now that it's just difficult to even know. And I've just almost purposed when it comes to anything political on social media, that is, I just leave it alone because it is so hot. And I really tried to purpose that when somebody posts something right now that I don't understand or that I don't agree with or that I don't know where they're coming from, I try to make a phone call.
Right.
Or send them a message and say, hey, let's talk about this. Let me see where you're coming from. And you can learn a lot about why somebody posted something just by asking those questions.
Absolutely. And, you know, it's so easy to project what you think they would have meant or what their motive was in doing it. But you could be totally off.
Well, you know, you have the Facebook forensic scientists out there, right?
Right.
These are the people that take the last 27 posts you made. They've seen all the 13 different things that you liked over here and this thing that you didn't like over here. And they've compiled this board with all the red yarn pieces pointing to one thing. And they've determined who you are and what you are. And so this post must be in the same context of what they've already painted about you in their mind. And so they take it the wrong way. And that's the problem sometimes with posting something that has no context. Is you think that somebody is coming across in a certain type of way, and really you didn't get what they're trying to say.
Right.
And that could be, you look at our president, his Twitter account. What has been the biggest criticism of him, even from his base, is his Twitter account. Because he puts these things out there that seem tone deaf or seem apathetic or seem angry without any context. And so social media can be a good thing, but it can also, when it comes to political things, can be very divisive. So I think you just got to be careful about just throwing out that post thinking you're going to save the world with one, you know, 160-character post.
You know, I think I would confuse those forensic scientists on Facebook because, like, I like things that are, you know, I mean, I don't even agree with that. But, man, that was a good, you know, hey.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? Why? Because I want things out there that are going to produce dialogue. You know what I mean?
Dialogue is very important.
Yeah, I actually had a friend mad at me because I liked something. Okay, and I am not a tech guy, okay? I'm not like this. I didn't even know that they could see my like.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you know what? I'm like, dude, you're mad at me because I like this. I go, it was good. It was written well. You know what I mean? And one person I said, man, they articulated that so good. And it just happened to be a black lady.
Yeah.
And somebody goes, would you say that about a white woman? I went, yeah. I was talking about articulation, ability to make her point clear.
Right. Yeah.
I go, I wish I had that ability. She's amazing. I might not even agree with her, but wow, what an amazing communicator. You know
absolutely
what I mean?
Absolutely.
And it's like, I couldn't even say that without it appearing to somebody as being a racist statement.
It's a tough thing right now. It is a tough thing right now to, and so again,
but I also see the other side of that.
Absolutely.
I really do. I mean, you know, Black Americans have been accused of not being articulate.
Yeah, they sure have.
So, I mean, I got it.
And I've tried to take this time to really learn and understand. If there's something that I don't know how to empathize with somebody, you know, I've talked to a lot of people. I lived in New York for 4 years, so I have a lot of friends of all different races. And I grew up in a very white town. I'll admit that. You know, the town I grew up in, Owosso, is like 98% white people. So I probably didn't grow up around a lot of diversity. But in New York, I lived there for 4 years, and I was around every creed, color, religion, race, and I got to know a lot of people and made a lot of friends. And I've made some phone calls in the past couple of months to ask questions because I want to learn. If there's something I'm uneducated about, I want to know. And again, it goes back to what we're talking about, is these types of conversations and this type of dialogue is very important. And that's why I'm so drawn to your podcast here, is because you're talking about wanting to have this dialogue with people of all different types of thoughts and mindsets. And I think it's extremely important because we don't have to agree.
Right.
We don't.
No.
But if we can understand each other,
right,
if we can empathize with each other, if we can see what's happened in someone's life or what background they have or what way they've raised or what religious beliefs they have that make them feel that way, it at least helps you understand why they would come to that conclusion.
And the diversity makes life good.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, my gosh. You know what I mean?
I wouldn't want to be around a bunch of people that are just like me. That'd be boring.
It would be boring. You know,
even though I'm pretty cool.
I mean, not going against that. I'm just saying that, you know, I mean, you know, I've had the privilege of being in a lot of different cultures.
Yeah.
And I really appreciate them all. And I see the hand of God, God's diversity being expressed in the different cultures. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And a pastor friend of mine passed away, and he just happened to be a black pastor of a black church and things mm-hmm. like this. And I got to be a part of the funeral. Mm-hmm. I want to get buried when I die in a black church.
Yeah.
I really do.
Yeah.
It was the funnest funeral I've ever been to. We cried together. We laughed together. We told stories. There was about four sermons. There was a flat-out worship set like crazy. I left there going,
black folks know how to worship, man.
Oh, my gosh. I left there going, I want to be a black man.
Yeah.
I'm serious. I mean, it was just like, it was so, it was the best funeral I've ever been to in my life.
Yeah.
Of course, the guy was a great guy. I mean, you know, he led so many people to the Lord and all this stuff. I hate it when you go to the funeral, you feel like you got to lie, you know, just do the eulogy.
Well, he was really good at paying his bills.
You know, you always button the shirt straight. You know, you got to say that about him.
Yeah, I've been to those.
Yeah, exactly. And I think so many times, I think what I see happening in our culture right now is trying to erase all the diversity almost.
Yeah. Trying to divide us.
Divide us.
Yeah, absolutely. No, I think it's absolutely true. And I think that's why we can't let it happen.
Yeah.
We have to take responsibility for yourselves. And I know people that have lost friends within the last couple of days even.
Yeah.
That have lost friends over an argument on social media.
Yeah, crazy.
And I thought to myself, this is not how it's supposed to be. Mm-hmm. This is what they want, whoever they are.
Right.
Somebody wants to divide us, and we're letting it happen. And I think, you know, when I listened to you on the Lantern podcast with the Stand Up Michigan guys, one of them asked you the question, what's the solution to all this?
Mm-hmm.
And you very simply said, and it stuck out to me, and it's resonated with me, no pun intended by the name of your church, that the solution is the truth.
Yeah.
And so my thoughts is I think we're all right now trying to look inward and say, what am I doing? What can I do? I'm just one person. What can I do to affect change? What can I do to impact those around me, to be a blessing, to be an encouragement, to inspire positivity? You know, nobody wants to live in a negative world. So especially me, I'm just such a upbeat person all the time. So, you know, all of this kind of negativity is a struggle for me. So, you know, I've tried to think, what can I do? And I come back to, what people need is the truth.
Right.
And not the truth about masks or the truth about COVID-19 or the truth about which lives matter.
Right.
The truth that Jesus Christ is Lord. That's the truth. That's what people need to hear. And I think as Christians, our focus needs to be not convincing people of who to vote for, or not convincing people of what political hoaxes are happening or conspiracy theories.
Right.
Although those are conversations that need to be had.
Yeah.
But if I'm going to convince a man of anything, I want to convince him that Jesus Christ is Lord.
You know, even if I convince somebody to vote for a certain person and if they die and go to hell,
what'd you do for them?
And zero.
Exactly.
A zero. Yep. Zero.
Yeah. If you get all kinds of non-mask wearing or mask wearing disciples and you did your thing, and at the end of the day, they didn't know about Christ and they spent eternity in hell, did you really help them?
Yeah. Zero.
Yeah, exactly.
Not a bit. You know, and for those of you maybe listening and you don't understand what we're dialoguing about at all when we talk about this, I just want to encourage you, God is real and he is not intimidated by your thoughts or maybe even your anger at a God that you don't believe in, or maybe you do believe in him and you're really mad at him. He loves you and he can handle your questions and your anger, and I encourage you to go to him and I encourage you to ask and dialogue and just say, if you're real, I need you to communicate to me.
Yeah.
I need you to talk to me. You know, when I got born again, this is literally what happened, okay? I was suicidal at that point in my life. I didn't want to live. And it's a whole story, you know, on all of that. This was my prayer, okay? Mm-hmm. I'll just lead up to this moment. I said, God, at this point, I believe there is a God. I believe you're out there. I said, I don't even want me. If you want me, you can have me. I don't think I'll ever be like any of these freaks. I was in a church.
These Jesus freaks.
They were freaky in my culture. I'm telling you that, man. I did not relate to one of them.
Yeah.
All right. You know, even the guy that brought me to church, I was having a hard time with.
Yeah.
I said, but if you'll take me, I can't guarantee I'll ever be like these freaks. I can't even guarantee I'll be a good Christian. But I said, if you'll take me, I won't deny you.
Wow.
I got a miraculous born-again experience that day.
That's powerful.
And it's that easy.
Yeah. And then you were free.
I was free.
You're free.
I literally walked through the threshold of my door. My wife looked at me and said, what the blank happened to you? I didn't even say anything. She saw the freedom on me. And she got born again 2 weeks later. We've been going 100 miles an hour ever since.
Yeah.
But when I want to get to people, sometimes they think, man, they got to know everything about God. They have to repent of all their sin. They have to. I couldn't even remember all my sin, let alone repent of all my sin.
Absolutely.
I accepted him. And that's the offer that Jesus is giving to all of us.
Mm-hmm.
I paid the price for your sin.
Right.
Let me absorb all your sin and I'll give you my life.
Absolutely. Well, and the key is not just believing in God, because a lot of people believe in God.
Demons believe in God.
In a higher power. The real difference is that you believe God.
Yes.
That you believe his word. And then when you believe his word, it's not that you automatically become this perfect person. Matter of fact, you actually start to realize how imperfect you are.
If you watch my podcast, you know that.
Right, exactly. Yeah. And you realize that's okay, because that's why Jesus Christ died.
Yeah.
And I believe that. And so I'm going to aspire to be better.
Yeah.
I'm going to aspire to be a better human and a better citizen and a better father and a better husband and a better employee and all of these things, because that's what's right.
Well, you know, but just like this conversation that we're having here, and I'm sorry I kind of cut you off.
That's
there.
All right.
But it's my podcast. So I can do that, I guess. But
you're anyway, the host, man.
Oh, you'll coach me on this later, right? Okay, hey, quit cutting me off.
Yeah, there was a part where you interrupted the guest, and we're going to have to work on that.
Don't do that. And, you know, I'm better because just the short interaction that you and I had, and that's called relationship.
Mm-hmm.
That's what Christ wants from us. He wants relationship.
That's it.
And as we hang out with him and we learn more about him and how good he really is, it changes who we are.
It sure does. Yeah.
And so many times people are trying to earn his love. No, you just got to walk in it. You just got to build this relationship with them. You know, a lot of times people say, what is salvation? They want me to, you know, break it down. Sometimes they want a theological dissertation of what this is. Yeah. Or
what is soteriology?
Right. You're right. Exactly. And I just go, really, this is it. It's in a relationship with a guy that just happens to be God, that just happened to pay the price for your sin.
Yeah.
That's what this is. Yep. That's what salvation is.
Yep.
I'm going to boil it down to the simplest term.
Yeah.
Do you want a relationship with God?
Yeah. And then you get to the point where you go back to church with all those freaks.
Yeah, yeah.
And you realize that no one's holding a gun to their head.
No.
They're being that way because they're compelled to be that way. They don't. Yeah. No one's making them do it. They just feel like, I believe in this God, and he's changed my life, and he's given me freedom, and he's given me a new outlook, and I just want to be good. And I'm going to mess up more times than I'm going to do it right, but I just want to keep doing it because that's what God wants me to do. And then you build that relationship with him. And, you know, I was talking to this with somebody about this earlier, that, you know, you start to become who you hang out with.
Yeah.
Right. And if you're hanging around people that are negative, you're just going to inadvertently become negative. And if you're hanging around people that are positive, you're probably going to become positive. And on down the line, you could say that with any type of activity, whether they're partiers or whether they're church going folks, you are going to somehow or some way become a product of your environment.
Mm-hmm.
And when you start hanging out with Jesus, you start going to his house and worshiping him. You start getting in his word and learning about him. You just want to become more like him.
Yeah.
You just look up to him. It's like that kid in high school that you looked up to and you wanted to be like, but on a much bigger level. You just want to be like Jesus. And so you aspire to do it. No one's forcing you to do it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not dutiful. And I would say this, if your Christianity is dutiful, you're doing it wrong.
Yeah. I would agree with that 100%.
You know, God wants you as you are. He wants you to come to him. He wants you to love him. He wants to have a relationship with you, but it's not this thing that has to be forced. And if you think that Christian people are perfect, or if you think that Christian people are even think to themselves to be perfect, then either you're around the wrong types of Christians, or you've just missed it. And so to me, you know, knowing Christ gives you this freedom.
Yeah.
You know, you hear a lot about this today. We're losing our freedoms.
Right.
And you hear people that they're afraid, the fear of death. And, you know, knowing Christ and having salvation, it gives you the freedom to be not afraid.
Right.
Even of death.
Right.
You know, the Bible teaches that God hasn't given us the spirit of fear.
Right.
But of power
mm-hmm.
and of love and of a sound mind. Boy, imagine just going through the world today with power.
Love.
With love and a sound mind.
Come on. You know what?
That would solve pretty much all your problems right there.
It would. Hey, we got the answer, everybody. We have it right
and
here
And the truth
you.
Shall set you free.
Yeah, oh, man, we're back to John. Okay, right. So, you know, what a great deal, you know. And so I just want to reemphasize one point. And then we'll close this thing down. Okay. But you're never going to, I think the Lord wants us to have empathy for people, but we'll never have that until we understand what they're feeling mm-hmm. and what they're going through. And I think as this debate goes on, Black Lives Matter or whatever's happening politically right now because the election's coming up and all mm-hmm. this other kind of stuff, COVID-19, all these different types of things. And I think we talked about it quite a bit, but it's like, I just want to encourage people, and I think you'd agree with me, have a dialogue. Mm-hmm. Find out where they're coming from.
And not a Facebook dialogue.
Oh. It is so, I'm going to say impossible. Mm-hmm. Because there's going to be way too much interpretation of mm-hmm. those words.
You can't see tone. You can't see expression. You can't see body language.
Right.
Just see words.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I told you about this earlier. I have two people that I know. Mm-hmm. Both I find to be kind, loving people. Mm-hmm. One in particular is probably the most, I refer to her to you when I tell you the story earlier, as the second most compassionate person I've ever met mm-hmm. outside of my grandmother who just passed. She is just such a compassionate person. Mm-hmm. And yet she's also passionate. Take the C-O-M off, and she's very passionate. And so she thinks, and she's a social justice warrior, mm-hmm. and she thinks that if she finds out something that would prevent people from losing their freedoms, that it is unwise of her to not post it on social media. It's so, her responsibility.
So she has this yeah. conviction,
right?
If I love like people, I have to do this.
I have to warn them, or else yeah. I'm being a bad friend or
right,
a bad
right.
whatever.
Okay.
And then this other one has the opposite point of view on what's going on with COVID, and that she believes that everybody should wear a mask and everybody should do exactly what the government tells you without asking any questions. And so she thinks that it's her responsibility to to warn people that by you not wearing a mask and by you not complying with the government, that you are unloving and uncaring and you don't care about people.
Right.
So I listened to both of them. And what I hear are two people that both want the same thing, and that is to love people and help people avoid something that's going to hurt them
right.
in their mind.
Uh-huh.
One thinks that if you don't do what the government says, you're going to kill people, and she can't fathom the idea of not warning people about that. The other thinks that if you just comply to every little thing, your freedoms are going to be stripped away from you one at a time. She thinks that if she don't warn them, that people are going to lose those things. And then these two meet uh-huh. on social media, not in person, never looked each other in the eye. The one has seen some of the things that she's been posting and already has determined she's hateful and doesn't care about people, and makes a statement, "I can't be silent anymore. You are the most hateful, uncaring person I have ever met. Your parents didn't raise you right, and I cannot believe that you call yourself a Christian," she put Christian in quotes, "and would be this unloving of people." Now, I read that and I think, wow, this girl is not what she's describing. But obviously, her messaging is bad, as, again, a branding person. And then she comes back with, "You don't know me, you don't know my life, and you're go ahead and give your freedoms away." And now you have these two people going at each other. All the while, they really are both just trying to do what they think is right. And what I tried to do in reading the entire 137 comment thread and wasting an hour of my time.
Oh, my gosh.
What I derive from that yeah. is these two people need to have a conversation.
Right.
Because they're going to find out that even though they don't agree on anything politically, they both care about people in their own way.
You know what? They probably would be great friends.
Probably.
Because they both love people.
And they're both passionate. And they both don't mind vocalizing their opinions.
Yeah.
And so I think that what I've been encouraging people to do and what I've been encouraging my friends to do is, if you hear something about somebody, you see something on social media, you see them at a rally, you see them here, you see something that you can't fathom why they would do it, call them.
Yeah.
It's that simple. Right now, we can't always be around everybody because we're told we got to keep our distance. But we have FaceTime, we have Skype, we have Zoom.
Yeah.
Get on, look them in the eye, ask them, "Hey, why did you do that? Help me understand." And I guarantee you 99.9% of the problems you have with people will be solved with a simple conversation,
yep,
with some dialogue.
I'd agree.
And then what we were talking about earlier, when you're listening to understand, not mm-hmm. listening to respond.
Yeah. And we need the diversity. You know,
absolutely.
Our government was designed that way. Our mm-hmm. government was designed to have parties that were opposite or different, so that there would never be a dictatorship
right.
and just one idea right. ruling over the other,
right.
you know, group
right.
of people. And yep. so I think life works that way too. God knows that we need diversity of thought, because there's no way we're grabbing on to the totality of God. I don't care how nice you are and how pure you think you are.
Right, absolutely.
You only have so much ability to see things and only have so much ability to deal with whatever's happening in front of you.
Diversity is what makes the world go round.
It is. It's so good.
So don't be afraid to surround yourself with people that don't think like you or act like you. Get to know them, understand them.
Yeah.
And what you might find, Christian, if you're listening, is that when you take the time to listen to somebody and hear their heart, you might find the opportunity to turn the conversation to Christ, and they can see your heart of compassion, not your heart of judgment.
Yeah, because, man, Jesus is so good.
He is. He is good. He's the truth. He's the answer.
Tony, a.k.a. Todd, since you mocked me on this. Why don't you tell everybody?
We got some things to talk about.
Yeah, we got things to talk about in this. Would you tell everybody how to get in contact with you, your business, if they want to find out more about maybe how you could help their business or whatever, how they get in contact with you?
Sure, yeah. You can find us at AZEE.co, AZEE.co. That's our website. We're on Instagram at AZEE.insta. We're on YouTube. We're on Facebook. We're on TikTok, I think. We're on LinkedIn. We're everywhere. And then we have a podcast called the No Easy Way Out podcast. You can find it on YouTube, Spotify, Google Play, Apple Podcasts, anywhere you can find a podcast. So go look us. You'll find us up. You'll find us somewhere or another.
You better be everywhere. Otherwise, I'm going to fire you, because you're supposed to get me everywhere.
Soon to be, he'll be everywhere.
Okay,
so, yeah,
good
absolutely.
Deal. It's AZEE.
C-O, yeah.
Yeah, C-O. So you can find that. And awesome. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
You are so welcome. You know what? And remember, God created you for greatness. Don't settle for anything else. I love you. Thanks for being with us. Hi, everyone. Thank you for watching today. If you liked what you heard, please subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell. Remember, you can listen to this podcast anywhere you search for podcasts and find them. You can find us. You were created for greatness. Don't settle for anything less. Thank you for watching. Till we see you next time on Raw Honey, be blessed.